Let us call on the Holy Spirit now. Let us ask the Holy Spirit and pour out His grace upon us. Come, Lord, Holy Spirit, we need You, Holy Spirit, Lord. Come, Lord, Holy Spirit, we need You. Come, Lord, Holy Spirit, and fall upon us now. Come, Lord, Holy Spirit, and sanctify this place. Make us holy, O Lord. Fill us with Your power, Father. Come, Lord, Holy Spirit, we need You. Come, Lord, Holy Spirit, we need You. Let us raise our hands and ask for the support, Holy Spirit, to fall upon us. Let us raise our voices. Let us raise our hands and ask the Holy Spirit to come and fall upon us. Let us ask the Holy Spirit to fill our hearts and set us apart.
Come, Holy Spirit, and fill my heart.
Come, Holy Spirit, set me apart.
Together.
Come, Holy Spirit, set me apart.
Even louder.
Come, Holy Spirit, to You I pray.
Let's implore Him to come.
Come, Holy Spirit, show me the way.
Come, Holy Spirit.
Come, Holy Spirit,
and heal me now.
And heal me now.
Come, Holy Spirit.
Come, Holy Spirit.
Help me now.
And
Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. We give you all glory and honor. We give you all worship and adoration. We give you all victory, power, and dominion. We belong to you, Abba, Father. We belong to Jesus. Touch the hearts of your people. Give them your grace. Together, everybody, hallelujah. Once again, we sing. Lord is moving in your midst. Tracy, God is calling you by name. Sunil D'Souza, God is blessing you. Annie, God is blessing you. Appu, God is blessing you. Christy, God is blessing you. Jasmine, God is blessing you. Somebody who had a growth in the uterus, God is healing you. You are supposed to go for a surgery. God is healing you without any surgery. Somebody you have severe spinal cord issues. The spinal cord is getting decayed in a way. God is setting you free. Somebody you have severe heart condition where your valves to the heart is blocked. God Himself is opening your valves and your heart is getting ready now. Somebody you have severe problem on your leg. You have walking difficulty. God is helping you. Somebody who came with crutches, you have difficulty to walk. The Lord is healing you. Many suffering from severe breathing problem, allergy problem. You are blocked. You have problem of breathing. God is healing you. Many with a spondylitis. Somebody were wearing a neck or the belt on a neck. God is setting you free from this severe spondylitis, neck problem. Some you had severe back pain, you are also using a belt. God is healing you. You no longer need to wear this belt. Somebody you have severe inflammation in your body, God is healing you, like swelling. God is healing you from this. Some of you have severe joint pains, severe arthritis, somebody having a rare condition of your blood, God is setting you free. Somebody having severe migraine, God is healing you. Someone you have toothache, not only the tooth, even your gums are paining. You cannot eat even food. God is healing you. Many with a sleeping disorder, God is healing you from this problem. A small child, a small child, having a kind of a diabetic condition, God is answering the prayer of the parents. God is healing this child. Once again, raise your hands. Together we sing, hallelujah. Cassia, God is blessing you. Sohail, God is blessing you. Susan, God is blessing you. Sam, God is blessing you. Aaron, God is blessing you. Pelagia, God is blessing you. Romeo, God is blessing you. Benny, God is blessing you. Joshi, God is blessing you. Jessian, God is blessing you. Lucy, God is blessing you. David, God is blessing you. Christina, God is blessing Christina. Seraph, God is blessing you. Shamin, God is blessing you. Shelina, God is blessing you. Let's give a mighty clap to the Lord and worship the Lord.
There's an important announcement, very urgent. Nissan number plate 11/7843 is blocking. Please, whoever it belongs to, please go immediately and remove it. And it is blue. Another car, Toyota white, number plate 3094. Thank you.
Let's kindly stand. Do you believe Jesus is here?
Yes.
Give a mighty clap to Jesus. Father Gasper has already announced that the confessions are going on. The priests are seated in different places. So kindly make sure you will all make confession. Yes. All those who have made confession, raise your hands. Thank you so much. Still remember, even when the preaching is going on, confession is going on. We need to make a confession. Something we should never forget, that you can never make a confession after your death. You can never make a confession after your death. You can never make a confession after your death. Kindly do it immediately. It's very important. One confession can make you a saint. After confession, you are not the same person. A new chapter is opened in your life. And it brings joy to the face of the Lord. Do you want to make Jesus happy?
Yes.
How can you make Jesus happy?
By going for confession.
Psalm 47:1. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
The Lord has healed many of you from severe back pain. All those who healed of this back pain from the day we started the retreat, kindly raise your hands. All those who had severe back pain, you feel God has healed you, raise your hands. Tomorrow is the day of testimonies, but it's important to acknowledge that the Lord is real. Also, some of you had walking difficulty, you had pain on the leg, and you met with accident, since then you had the problem. All those who had pain on the legs, you are finding it difficult to walk, kindly raise your hand. You feel God has healed you. Lift your hand. Let's give a mighty clap to the Lord. There are many mothers, you are very, very anxious about your children, their future, their behavior, very much upset about your children, the way they behave. Kindly be seated. One day a mother brought a 13-year-old girl and she said, "Father, this girl misbehaves. And she is just rebellious. She just do the things that I say the opposite. I'm very upset. And I can find that my daughter has many boyfriends at this small age. And I'm very angry with the way she behaves. This is not the way I wanted my daughter to behave. So the mother was very upset about her daughter. While the mother is talking, the Lord gave this word of God from Titus. This is St. Paul's letter to Titus, chapter 3, from 2. This is what the Lord said. To speak evil of no one, to avoid quarreling, to be gentle, and to show every courtesy to everyone. For we ourselves were once foolish, disobedient, led astray, slaves to various passions and pleasures, passing our days in malice and envy, despicable, hating one another. But when the goodness and loving kindness of our God, our Savior, appeared, He saved us, not because of any works of righteousness that we had done, but according to His mercy. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
So when this mother is complaining about her daughter who is 13 years, who is misbehaving, the Lord asked this particular mother like this. How were you when you were 13 years? We asked this mother. She told me in a low voice, I was worse, father. That is why the Lord is telling this mother, speak evil of no one. Don't speak evil of your daughter. Avoid quarreling with your daughter. To be gentle with your daughter. Show every courtesy with your child. Because you yourself have received God's mercy. That God is the same. He will also show mercy upon your daughter and will convert. And we asked her, what about you today? She said, Father, today I am very prayerful. I realized my mistakes. I am very good now. That's what I feel. She told. We said, don't worry. Let us read this word of God together, louder, everybody. Look onto the screen. Let's read together. To speak, read loud. To avoid quarreling. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Saint Augustine got converted. After he got converted, you know, Augustine led his life in very wrong path. He was an alcoholic. He was into empty philosophy. He lived with a woman. He got a child out of wedlock. He was never believing in God. It's only his mother who believed out of the prayer of this mother. 17 years this Monica prayed and shed tears, and Augustine got converted. And now after the conversion of Augustine, now he prayed like this. He was 33 years then. He asked Jesus like this, my Lord Jesus, why did you permit me to commit such sins all my life? You could have killed me when I was 23 years. I could not have committed such bad sins and brought shame upon you. Now I feel extremely guilty that how could I do such things? Why you did not punish me when I was so young? If you had punished me, I could not have brought such shame upon you. Augustine is making his confession to Jesus. Then Jesus told Augustine, my son, I permitted it for two reasons. First, so that you may be humble and you may depend on me. If you depend on yourself, this is what you can do. You will defile my name. This is to make you humble, because by yourself you can only commit a sin. John 15:5, you can do nothing apart from me. Praise the Lord. And the second thing Jesus told him is that, so that you may be compassionate and merciful. So that you don't judge others. So that you may be merciful to sinners like you. When people go astray, they fall down, they repeat the same sins. You don't judge them. Instead, you will be compassionate to them. Augustine became a priest, then a bishop. He used to write pastoral letters. Augustine never accused, never blamed, never humiliated anyone. He used to quote that, I am a forgiven sinner. I am a forgiven sinner. As you are attending this Inner Healing Family Renewal Retreat at this Holy Family Co-Cathedral in Kuwait City, the Lord is reminding us, we are all forgiven sinners. We are all forgiven sinners. We were all sinned terribly, but our Master forgave us, so that we don't judge, criticize, evaluate, or belittle anyone. We may have that compassionate heart. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
And always remember, Saint Paul said about himself, who he was. 1 Timothy 1:13-15. Saint Paul says, I was formerly a blasphemer, a man of violence. I was a persecutor. But the Lord showered his mercy upon me. This saying from 13. The saying is sure and worthy of full acceptance, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am the foremost. Saint Paul is telling that I received mercy. From 13 we read. 1 Timothy 1:13. Who he was and from where he received this mercy. He's telling, I myself was a sinner, but God gave me mercy. 1 Timothy 1:13. 1 Timothy 1:13. Formerly, I was a blasphemer, a man of violence, and a persecutor. But I received mercy because I acted ignorantly. Today, as we are here, we know we are not perfect. And he says one particular thing is full of acceptance. That is, Christ Jesus came for sinners. All those who believe you are a sinner, kindly raise your hands. Even me, I'm a sinner. So smile, please. It's for you Jesus came. If you are a saint, you can slowly get up and disappear. It's not for you. It's only for sinners. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Jesus said that no one is rejected. John 6:37. I will not reject anyone who comes to me. In this anyone includes you and me. In this anyone includes a prostitute, a thief, a murderer, a robber, a terrorist, everyone. I will not reject anyone who comes to me. Look in the life of Jesus. Many came to Jesus. Sick came, they got healed. Possessed came, they got delivered. The hungry came, they got fed. The rich came, they got fulfilled. The Samaritan woman came, she received the power of the Holy Spirit. Mary Magdalene came, she became an apostle. Anyone who came to Jesus, Jesus never rejected them. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
So when anyone comes to Jesus, They are a new creation. 2 Corinthians 5:17. Those who are in Christ Jesus, they are a new creation. Praise the Lord. So even your son, your daughter, maybe you think they are far away from God. But one day, they will be closer to God. Jesus said a parable. This parable is the parable of the weeds. This is Matthew chapter 13, verse 29. Matthew 13:29. He replied, "No, for in gathering the weeds, you would uproot the wheat along with them. Let both of them grow together until the harvest time." Jesus is telling, don't remove the weeds. Let it be there. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
You know, for us, the prodigal son is like a weed that is to be removed. We may have treated some people as a weed. I have heard in our place where we are born, certain plants in the past were considered to be a weed, like a poisonous weed that is not good. So we used to remove it. Later, through scientific research, it was found that those were herbal plants that has medicinal value. And those same plants we considered as a weed once upon a time is now very, very precious plants because we did not know. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Maybe you yourself, your parents may have told, you are stupid. You are a donkey once upon a time. After coming to Kuwait, you are a queen. You are a princess. They call you so many good things. Why? They need something out of you. Sisters and brothers, Saint Augustine was considered to be a weed when he was 24 years. When he was 33 years, he started to turn to God. Saint Therese of Lisieux encountered God when she was just 13 years. Augustine, 33 years. There's a saint called Saint Nicholas of Flue from Switzerland. He started to follow God only after he was 50 years old, around 60 years. So he is considered to be a weed when he was 40 years. There is no one who is a gone case before God. The one whom you consider is not close to God, maybe a saint in the making. That's why we cannot judge anyone. Maybe a husband whom you think is a drunkard today, not responsible, not believing in God, not going to church. Maybe a saint in the making. That is the power of
Jesus.
Praise the Lord.
There is a superpower for Jesus. This power no human has. This power is called the one who can bring good out of evil. This is Catechism of the Catholic Church number 412 says like this. God permits evil because he can bring good out of evil. There is no one who can bring good out of evil. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
So whatever happens in your life, whatever situations that you are going through in your life, once you surrender your life at the feet of Jesus today, things will change. There are so many different beautiful names for Jesus. He's the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Prince of Peace, the Good Shepherd, the Lord of all creation. But one particular name that he has is like this, the Great I Am. The Great I Am. Say his name.
The Great I Am.
Once again.
The Great I Am.
That means your past is never a problem for him. You may have a stinging past, a very sinful background. today, if you are willing to surrender your life at the feet of the Lord, maybe you are 80 years, 70 years, 17 years, 12 years, if you are willing to surrender your life to Jesus at His feet, you will become a new creation. Praise the Lord. Inner healing. Today, we deal with inner healing. It's all about surrendering our wounds at the feet of the Lord to become a new creation. And it will happen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We used to ask a question to the people when we conduct inner healing retreat. The question is very simple. Who is the most cruel animal in the forest? For you, what do you think the most cruel animal in the forest? Lion. Okay, actually lion is not very cruel. Only when it is hungry, it may attack. And the male lions never attack. Hyena. Okay. Then?
I agree with Lester.
Wild dog.
They say, you know, some people told me mosquitoes are the most cruel. Because maximum people die of mosquito bites than all these things. And some people say snakes are the most cruel animals. Those who say snakes, lift your hands. Those who say snakes are the most cruel animal. Okay, there are many lifting the hands. You know, when you lift the hand, you know what does it mean? You are afraid of snakes.
Yes.
That is the way inner wounds come out. The question is the most cruel animal in the forest, not the animal you fear the most. They say the wounded animal is the most cruel animal. A wounded animal, because it's wounded, so it is vulnerable. It can attack anyone. Then who is the most cruel two-legged animal? Those who have two legs. We are a wounded person. They say Hitler was a wounded person. That's why he became cruel. Now I have a question to ask you. Very, very important question. Who is the most wounded person ever lived on this earth?
Jesus Christ.
Who is the most wounded person who ever lived on this earth? Jesus. According to St. Bridget of Sweden, there was more than 5,480 wounds in the body of Jesus. Now the question is, who is the most powerful healer ever lived on this earth?
Jesus.
Give a mighty clap to Jesus. Therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, we have great hope. If you are wounded, you can become a healer. As Christians, as believers, as we belong to Jesus, our wounds are our treasures. He can make use of the same wounds to make us His instruments of healing and salvation. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
I was a missionary in Kenya. One day, a girl came to me with two little kids. She is very small. So she brought me two kids and she told me, "Father, bless me with my kids." I felt a little angry because she's, you know, in Africa, in Kenya, you can have kids even without getting married. I thought she's a single mother. So I just asked her, "Are these your children?" She said, "Yes, these are my kids. Bless me with my kids." Then I asked her, "Are you married?" She said, "No, I'm not married." Then I said, "How can you have kids without marriage?" Then she told me, "But Father, these are my adopted children." I asked her, "Adopted? How old are you?" She said, "I am just 20 years. I asked, "Do you have a job?" She said, "I completed my degree. I have a small job. I can provide for these kids." But I told her, "But is it not a high risk? Who will marry you with these kids? Who will believe these are adopted children? Are you telling the truth?" She said, "Yes, Father, these are orphans. They don't have parents. And I'm like a mother to them. They call me Mama." Then I asked her, "What about you?" Then she told me, "Even me, Father, I'm an orphan." And she told me like this, Father, you will not understand what I am doing because you are not an orphan. I know these kids need a mother right now, and I am trying to be a mother to them. Sisters and brothers, she is a great woman, just 20 years. She told me, Father, I am an orphan, but God was so gracious to me. People adopted me. They looked after me. They provided for me. And I want to do the same. I want to be a healer. I don't want these kids to grow up in any hostel or institution. They need a physical mother. And I am trying. And I pray to the Lord, give me a husband who accept me with these adopted kids. Sisters and brothers, this is Isaiah chapter 50 verse 4. Isaiah chapter 50:50 verse 4. The Lord God has given me the tongue of a teacher, that I may know how to sustain the weary with a word. The Lord God has given me the tongue of a teacher. Let's read together. The Lord God has given me how to sustain the weary with a word. Morning by morning he wakens my ear to listen as those who are to. The Lord himself became a teacher to her. If we read this word of God, if we interpret it into her life, it goes like this. The Lord God has made me an orphan so that I may know how to sustain the orphans with a word. The Lord helped me to go through the wounds, and he gave me the grace to overcome it so that I may become a wounded healer. Just surrender that particular wound you have gone through. It can be rejection, it can be fear, it can be sorrow, it can be loneliness. It can be the death of someone in your family. Once you overcome that particular sorrow in your life, that particular sickness in your life, you are going to become an instrument of healing, a channel of divine grace. Praise the Lord. So we don't want to be ashamed of inner wounds. We don't want to hide it. If we have inner wounds, there are three problems. The first thing, you will hurt yourself. The second thing, you will hurt others. The third thing, you will form bad habits in you. So you need healing. Inner healing has other problems too. First, it will block you to do good. Romans 7:15, I do the very thing I hate because there is a principle of evil in me. Because of inner wounds, even if you do want to do good, you cannot. For example, fear blocks you to do good. Sorrow blocks you to do good. Depression, loneliness, shame, feelings of rejection, inferiority complex, self-pity, self-hatred. All these are, we think it is something very small, but these are not small. These can paralyze your life. I do remember a mother brought a particular girl, 7 years, and the mother said like this, Father, pray for my daughter. My daughter is always sick. I take her to the hospital. Doctors cannot find any sickness. Today she complains of headache. I give her medicine for headache. Then she tells me she has toothache. I give her medicine for toothache. Then she says she has stomach pain. I give medicine for stomach pain. Then she says she has back pain. I give medicine for back pain. Then she says she has ear pain. I give medicine for ear pain. Then she says she has pain all over her body. Father, I think this girl is possessed with the demon of sickness. She's always sick. She's never healthy. I don't know what kind of medicine I can give to my daughter. While we were praying, we asked her about her husband. Then she said that they are separated. They are separated. They are no longer together. Sisters and brothers, we just told this mother, I can tell you the sickness of your child. Your daughter is suffering from a sickness called rejection. This little girl is crying for love. When this girl is telling, I have stomach pain, this child is crying, is there a dad who can embrace me with little love? My dear sisters and brothers, This sickness can only be healed by God's love. You yourself imagine something very simple, normal. If you live in a hostile situation, in your family, if there is always fight, hatred, fighting with the parents, you will fall sick immediately. You go to an office and you find the situation in the office is always hostile, hatred. You will feel you are sick. But there is love, there is no sickness. But there is fighting. That climate, that atmosphere itself creates sickness. It's not healthy at all. So we need this healing through Jesus and Jesus alone. And this is a reality. Many, their personality is deformed. They're not able to, there are people cannot take decision properly. They get angry for small things. They are very sensitive. They feel crying for small things. They are extremely emotional because we have not surrendered our wounds at the feet of Jesus and we have failed to invite him into every area of our life. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Pray after me, Jesus.
Jesus,
I invite you
into my life.
Jesus,
my master.
Where else I will go?
Help me.
Jesus,
Jesus,
I invite you
into my wounds.
Come, Lord Jesus.
This
is about Saint Josephine Bakita. She's a saint from Sudan. Bakita means good luck. It is not her name. She was a slave. She was being transferred from one slave, some masters, four different slave masters. Finally, Bakita reached Italy with an Italian slave master because he lost his wife while giving birth. So Bakita was adopted to be a slave to look after his daughter. Later, this man tried to abuse her, so Bakita ran away in Italy and entered into a church like this. The priest found her. In Italy, those days, there were very few black people. So now Bakita entered into that church. Then the priest asked her, "Why are you here?" She said that, "I am running away because they tried to abuse me." The priest said, "You are safe here. You can stay in this church." Then Bakita noticed there was a huge crucifix. She knows those days in Sudan, the slaves were hanged on the cross. Crucifixion were the punishment for the slaves even those days in Sudan. So she thought, even here, she has no salvation. She can even be hanged on the cross. So she asked this priest, "Who is this hanging on the cross?" Then the priest said, "This is our God." Then Bakita asked, "How can this be God? Is he not a slave? In our place, slaves hung on the cross." Because Bakita was a pagan. She was a Gentile woman. She does not know about Christ or Christianity. She was born in Sudan having no knowledge at all about Christ or Christianity. Now the priest explained Jesus was a slave. Then she asked, "How can you say he is a God and at the same time he is a slave? He cannot help himself. His hands are on the nails. His feet are on the nails. He cannot help himself. Then how can this be God? He cannot help himself." Then the priest explained, "He is God and the slave at the same time. Philippians chapter 2, 7 and 8. He took the form of a slave. He emptied himself and he took the form of a slave. That means he was lower than humans. Jesus was on earth. He lived as a slave." And the priest explained, "Kings are born in palace, but our Lord Jesus, our God, was born in a manger among cattle and sheep because he was a slave. He was riding on a donkey. Those days, kings ride on horses. But Jesus traveled on donkey. Donkey were the means of transport for slaves. And the priest explained, Jesus was sold just for 30 silver coins. These 30 silver coins were the price of a slave. Kings never washed anyone's feet. Jesus washed the feet of his disciples. He just proved, I am just a slave. He was buried in a higher tomb. He was covered with torn clothes. He was a slave. Bakita started to cry. The priest also explained there was more than 5,480 wounds in the body of Jesus. Bakita touched her back. All the slave masters, whenever they feel angry, they used to beat Bakita. All her back. Blood used to come and they never used to treat her, never take her to hospital. So she could not even sleep properly. Pain all over her body because she was just a slave. She started to cry. From that day onwards, she will just come and sit in the church, look at the crucifix, cry from morning to evening. She poured out her pain, her tears, her sorrows at the feet of Jesus. She became a profound saint. She joined the Canossian sisters, and we know the history. Bakita, from being a slave, she became a saint. We read in Psalm chapter 34, verse 5, Psalm 34, 5, look to him and be radiant, so your face shall never be ashamed. Please repeat this word of God together louder. Look to him, so your face shall never be. Once again together, look to him, so that your face shall never be. Once again, so your face shall never be ashamed. Imagine Bakita looked at Jesus and her face became radiant, and never again she felt ashamed. She found the meaning of her life in Jesus. Otherwise, she was ashamed of herself because she was a slave. Now she found, she said, if there is a God on this earth, this is my God. This is the God who can understand my pain as a slave. And she surrendered her life to Jesus. There are people, when they misbehave, when they get angry, when they get upset, when they become violent, when they abuse drugs or drink alcohol, do you know what they say? Because I'm wounded, I'm empty, I'm sorrowful, I suffered too much. They have failed to look to Jesus and to become radiant. Sisters and brothers, every pain a human has suffered in their life is once suffered by Jesus. And once you get identified your pain with the pain of Jesus, you receive inner healing. Bakita could have become a criminal. If she has all the right to become a criminal, but she became a saint. That is the power of inner healing. If you look at the history of people who became criminals, why? Because they think no one suffered like them. We read in Hebrews chapter 4 from 15. Hebrews 4:15. We do not have a high priest who is unable to sympathize in our weaknesses. Instead, we do have one who suffered in every respect that we have gone through. Let's read together this word of God, together, wherever you are. For we do not have with our weakness, but we have one who in every respect has been tested as we are, yet without. See, when you have a suffering, somebody told me like this, Father, I think I am the most rejected person. There is no one who is rejected as I am. I helped too many people, but in my need, there is no one to help me. We just told him, imagine, Jesus is standing, Barabbas is standing. The Jewish people whom Jesus helped, the same people who ate the bread multiplied by Jesus, whom he healed, whom he set free, whom he delivered. Those people are in front of him. And Barabbas the criminal. And Pilate asked them a question. Whom do I release? They cried, crucify Jesus, free Barabbas. Somebody, when I was in UK, called me and told me, Father, pray. I asked him for what? He told me, Father, you pray very hard for me because today is the verdict. And he told me, Father, you know, me and my wife, we are separated. And we are on the final stage of separation. And now the decision regarding our children, we have two children. Today, the court has to decide the children should go with whom? With me or with my wife? And he told me, Father, it will be a heartbreaking situation if my children choose my wife more than me. It will be a pain. It will be a deep rejection for me. So he asked him, then what about your wife if they choose you? Then he said, definitely she will be wounded. So I told him, so what I have to pray for you or for your wife? Sisters and brothers, rejection is such a painful thing. Rejection is such a painful thing if you are going through in that. Look at Jesus, how he suffered. And we read, this is 1 Peter 2:21 onwards. This example he has set. He committed no sin, and no deceit was found in his mouth. When he was abused, he did not return abuse. When he suffered, he did not threaten. For to this you have been called. Together let us read. For to this you have been called. Because Christ also suffered for you, leaving you an example, so that you should allow in his steps. He committed no sin, and no deceit was found. When he was abused, he did not return abuse. When he suffered, he did not threaten. But he entrusted himself to the one who judges justly. He was abused, but he did not return abuse. He suffered, but he did not threaten anyone. Sisters and brothers, when I was small, I advised Jesus. You know, it is very wrong to advise Jesus. But I did that big mistake because Jesus can never get angry with you. He has no problem. Only humans will get upset. I advised Jesus. I told him like this, Jesus, it was a mistake that you just disappeared after 40 days of your resurrection. If you had stayed long on this earth, you could have saved so many souls. Now you entrusted this big duty of evangelization to us, and we have failed you. Even now, only 2.4 billion people know about Christ. You have just disappeared all of a sudden, putting this duty upon us unfaithful people. Even me, I cannot do much. If you had stayed back with many miracles, and I told Jesus in this way, at least you could appear before Pontius Pilate and give him at least 2 slaps on his face so that he may learn a lesson and don't repeat the same thing. I advised Jesus, it was very important after the resurrection you should come before Herod, keep him in the collar, lift him in the air for 2 minutes, keep him in the air and drop him. But he did not do that. I asked Jesus, why you did not do that? Then a voice came to me like this, my son, do you know who is this Herod and Pontius Pilate? They are also my children. I came also to save them. I came to take the last place. I came to serve, not to be served. I came to die. I came to empty myself. Sisters and brothers, if we know who is Jesus, we will receive healing. Every wound that you say you have suffered, there are people who say, there is no one who suffered like me. There are people who say like that. We are totally ignorant. You know, one day a lady told me like this, Father, I am a sorrowful woman. I told her, I have heard this only about Mother Mary. Now you are also saying like that. She said, Father, I am suffering too much. I asked her, how long? She said, Father, long time, actually since I got married, I don't know what is peace in my life. I suffered too much. Then I told her, do you know how much Jesus suffered? Then she told me, Father, don't tell me anything about Jesus. He only suffered 3 hours on the cross. Me, I am suffering 33 years since my marriage. I told her, you are very wrong. Jesus even told Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me? The reason, Lord, even today, when people are not accepting suffering, they are crucifying Jesus. They are suffering. Jesus is suffering. And if we know who is Jesus and how he suffered, and still how he wants us to experience him, then only your life will change. Your suffering has a meaning in Jesus. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
You are suffering, any suffering that you take, you will find it with Jesus. And that will be the healing. Bakita, when she looked at Jesus, she found Jesus was a slave like her, and she got healed. You say you are rejected, you look at Jesus, and you find Jesus was more rejected than you. You receive healing. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
When you say that you have gone through misunderstanding, you are betrayed, you find Jesus was betrayed. This is Psalm 55. This is 12 to 14. Psalm 55, 12 to 14. See, there are people who say, I am cheated by my own business partner. I started a company. Later on, my friend took my company, put it in his name, stole all my money, made me to be imprisoned, made me to suffer too much. And you think that it is right and just to keep grudge against him, to file case against him. Then you look at Jesus, and Jesus start telling you, Psalm 55, 12 to 14. It is not together, louder, everybody. It is not enemies. But it is you, my equal, my companion, my familiar friend, with whom I kept pleasant company. We walked in the house of God with the throng. See, this is about Jesus, the prophecy, how Judas, his own disciple, betrayed. It is not enemies or a stranger who did this to me, one of my own disciple. Psalm 41:9. Psalm 41:9. The same thing is been as a prophecy, it has come. Psalm 41:9. Even my bosom friend, together louder, even my bosom friend, in whom I trusted, who ate of my bread, has lifted the heel against me. This is about Judas. Jesus is telling, the one who cheated me, the one who betrayed me, is not my enemies or a stranger, one of my own. Maybe you are deceived by your husband. He separated you, who made you an orphan. He has abandoned you with your children. You are going through that agony, that pain. Remember, when you look at Jesus, he suffered the same way you suffered. Maybe you are a widow. You have no one to help. Remember, Jesus had no one, and he is there to help you. You say that you suffered from your own friends. Remember, Jesus suffered. Then what is example he set? An example of love. Somebody pierced into his heart. That person received healing. You know that. Blood and water came out and healed that soldier who only had one eye. the otherwise was damaged, it got healed. So a Christian means anyone who comes to wound you, hurt you, humiliate you, they should receive a blessing and a healing. This is what the Lord is teaching us. We have to become wounded healers. This is Isaiah 53, 4 and 5. By his wounds we are healed. This is the same thing he wants us to do. Inner healing means to become channels of healing for others. Together we read, surely he has borne and carried our diseases. If by the wounds of Jesus we are healed, the wounds that we go through should become also a channels of healing. In Kigali, there is a special prayer group we have gone to conduct a service. This prayer group is for childless couples. There are 400 childless couples gathered in Kigali for this prayer service. This is a prayer group founded by a lady called Miriel. She told me why she started. She was initially a childless person. She had 3 miscarriages. Then only she got 3 kids. Then she said, now she is a mother, she is a wife, she has 3 kids, but she has a prayer group. She started with 4 couples, then 25, 40, then it became 400. Most powerful prayer I have seen, Miriel said. When she was going through this crisis of childlessness, miscarriage, there were many people started questioning her, why you have no child, why you have miscarriage, what is the problem, is there somebody who did witchcraft? She said she suffered a lot because there is no one to consult with, no one to pray, no one to understand her pain having no child. Then she said, then she understood she is not the only one suffering in the same way. She said, then I thought of joining the people going through the same pain. And I started this prayer group. And she said, this is a special prayer group because they know only God can help them. Medicine cannot help. Doctors cannot help. Science cannot help. It's only God. So we come together. They forget about themselves. They praise and worship the Lord. And since then, many receive the blessings of children when they have joined their pain together and worshipped God. Miriel said, only because I had this problem of childlessness, miscarriages, I could become an instrument of healing for others. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Let's kindly stand. Let's ask the Lord. Living waters flow on. Wipe away my pain. Let's remember the power of the Lord. The healing touch of the Lord. He is our healer. He is our savior. Jesus means one who saves and one who heals. He can transform our life. He is here. He is real. He is not a myth. He is not a story. He is a person. He is our God. And he wants to communicate with us. He wants to heal our wounds. Every wound of maybe failure, you failed in the same exam many times, it will become a treasure once you receive that inner healing from God. Maybe you failed in your business. Maybe you failed in your job. Maybe you lost your job. You are going through a terrible time in your life. You have deep financial crisis. You have poverty. Don't worry. Once you receive healing from the Lord, you'll become a new creation. Living waters flow on.
Living waters. Sweep away my
and worship the Lord. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Lord, we love you, we praise you, we worship you, we adore you. Let everyone who are here receive your power, your healing, your anointing. The Lord is healing somebody who has severe hip joint pains. It's long time you were affected by this. Your walk is also affected. Your job is affected. God is healing you from this hip joint pain. You are suffering from long time. There are also some you have severe gastric problem and acidity. God is also healing you from this. Some you have a strange kind of pain on the left side of your head. God is healing you from that problem. Somebody you had a stroke once and you are very much afraid will it come back again. God is healing you from this problem, even the fear of you will fall sick. Also, there is someone you have brain tumor, it was operated, and now again you are thinking there is some problem that it is recurring. God is blocking it, He is healing you permanently and He is helping you. God is calling Sebastian by name and God is telling, I have already intervened in all your difficulties. God is also consoling Stephen. God is telling, I know you, my son. I'm going to help you out. God is going to intervene in your life. Psalm 47:1. Let's clap our hands and worship the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Kindly be seated again. When I was small, I'm born in a family of 10 children. I'm the 9th born. The last born is my sister. When I was small, I used to talk a lot. You know, in our place, very few people have 10 children, maximum 2 or 3 children, even those days too. So whenever we go for a party or a function, we will take in turns. We don't go all of us. If my brothers have gone for one, then the others will go. So one day I was supposed to go. Then my mother told me, you are talking too much. And you are a boy, you cannot speak like woman. So I don't take you. So I used to talk too much and ask so many questions. Today I know it was wrong. Why you need love, attention. When you are a child, you are competing for love and attention. That's why I was talking too much. Today I know, I am sorry for that. But those days you are ignorant when you are a child. So my mother told me, because you are talking too much, I will not take you. I was around 6 or 7 years old. So, and she went with my sister for the marriage, the party of the relative. So we have a small prayer room. I entered into the prayer room and I knelt down and I prayed to Jesus, Jesus, please make me mute. I don't want to speak anything. I don't know why I talk too much. I don't like to talk, but I don't know. So many words come out from today. I don't want to talk anything. Because for me as a child, I just want to go with my mother for the party. I prayed and the miracle happened. The miracle is that Jesus did not answer my prayer. Instead, he told me like this, my son, don't worry. Your mother may be tired of your talk, that you talk too much. But my son, I will choose you and you will talk for me 24 hours. Look to him and be radiant so that your faces shall never be ashamed. The same weakness people accused you, the same drawback that people set you apart will be the same thing. God will choose you. This is inner healing. Sisters and brothers, there is no one who is perfect. We are humans. We are weak. We are incomplete. We are imperfect. We need Christ. Without Him, we are nothing. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
I want to share with you my inner healing. Somebody told me, a priest, after my ordination, "Father, you have a problem. You have suppressed anger." I accepted. I have it. Suppressed anger means it's an inner wound. Many of you have it. If you have suppressed anger, please don't raise your hand. Hide it. We need to receive that healing today. Suppressed anger means what? You don't get angry. You'll even smile. But if you get angry, you can even become violent. You don't get angry easily, but once you get angry, you cannot control yourself. It's suppressed anger because you have suppressed all the negative feelings, the false accusations, the humiliations, the injustice, everything. Because you cannot express, you just suppressed it. Then comes a time, a circumstance comes in, it will just explode. So we need healing in every area. We cannot just pretend that I'm okay. Oh, it's okay. There is no problem. That's why some people, they are very good until they get married. After getting married, all these inner wounds come out and they cannot survive at all. And then you will surprise. Is it the same person I thought to be married? We need inner healing. No family can properly survive if we have not received inner healing. It is very crucial. It's very important. And we don't want to be afraid because Jesus is a healer. He's waiting. He said, "Come to me." Matthew 11:28. "You who are weary and heavy burdened, I will give you rest. I will give you healing." John 14:27. "I leave you peace. My peace I give to you." He is the Prince of Peace. He can bring the peace once we give our life to God. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Those who are outside the church, though you cannot see the altar, Jesus can see you.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Only those who are outside will say, "Praise the Lord." Hallelujah. My dear sisters and brothers, this priest told me, "Father, you sit in front of the Blessed Sacrament, you ask Jesus, and Jesus will heal you because your past is present before Jesus. He is the same yesterday, today, and forever. No science, no technology, no advice, no medicine, no doctor can heal us or give us inner healing. It's only Jesus. It's only Jesus who became human, who knows us." As Saint John Paul II said, Jesus had hands like you, eyes like you, ears like you, heart like you. He was a human like you. So there is no one in this world who can understand the pain of a human like Jesus. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
And at the same time, He is God. And there is healing. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. And believe me, healing is possible. Do you believe that?
Yes.
Then smile, please. It's possible. We can change. It is possible. So I started to sit before the Lord, asking the Lord to reveal to me my inner wounds. There are 7 steps to receive inner healing. 7 steps. The first one, invite Jesus into your present problem. First, invite Jesus into your present problem. Maybe your present problem is instability, problem of decision making, getting angry very fast, fear for small things, anxiety, stress, self-pity, suicidal feeling, feelings of rejection, unwanted feeling, getting upset for small things. Anything that you have, your personality problem. your present crisis, maybe sickness, always you fall sick, invite Jesus into your present problem. Because your present, your past is present before Jesus. He knows how, when, why you are going through this. And the second is invite Holy Spirit into the root memory. Into the root memory. There is a root cause. Why do you like this? Maybe you are addicted to a particular sexual sin. What is the root sin? What is the first incident you were introduced into something that is immoral or impure that has grabbed you? Invite, ask Holy Spirit to reveal to you the root memory. The third step, forgive everyone caused that pain. Maybe your parents, maybe your friends, maybe a teacher, maybe a priest, maybe anyone whom you held with high esteem, anyone who caused that pain, forgive them. The fourth step, praise and worship the Lord for the pain you have suffered. As we have already seen, the inner wounds, once we receive healing, it can become a channel of blessing for others. So it's important that we give thanks and praise to the Lord for every suffering that we go through, because the same sufferings God can use as a channel of blessing for others. And the fifth step, ask the holy blood of Jesus to wash that wound and heal you. The blood of Jesus, 1 John 1:7, the blood of Jesus cleanses us from all sin. The blood of Jesus has the power to heal our unconscious mind. Everything that is not healthy, Jesus, the blood of Jesus has purchased us. And the sixth step, ask the Holy Spirit to fill you. The emptiness that you have, remember the apostles, they had full of fear. They did not like suffering. But we read in Acts 4:31, they rejoiced that they were worthy to suffer disgrace for the sake of the name of the Lord. See, they were flogged, they were beaten up, they suffered. In the past, they rejected suffering. But when Holy Spirit came upon them, they rejoiced in the sufferings that they endured. The transformation takes place when Holy Spirit comes in. The seventh step, ask Abba Father to be your true Father, to be your heavenly Father. Abba Father gives you that guarantee, that protection, that safety that you need in your life, and you will truly experience His presence. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
So with this instruction, I sat before the Lord to receive inner healing. Then the Holy Spirit, I invited Jesus into my problem of suppressed anger. Then the Lord started to reveal to me, when I was small, around 6-7 years old, I told you I'm born in a family of 10 children. My mother, father, and we are 10, we are 12 total. So my mother has to cook in the kitchen, she has to do all the housework. My father is a farmer, and whenever I do some mistakes. You know, when I am small, I used to be very bad, very naughty, fighting with everyone, especially fighting with my sister. You know, I am the 9th born. My sister is 3 years younger to me. She is the last born. You know, in our place, the last born is treated as the most important. The other borns are not as important. The last born get all the attention. So when I was the last born, I got all the love. When my sister is born, nobody wanted me. When people bring sweets, it will be given to my sister. Because she is angry with me, she will not give me. So I will pinch her hand, I will pull her hair. Small thing, she will scream. The moment my sister screams, my mother will come with a stick, take me to the prayer room, make me to pray Hail Mary, and she will beat me. If I cry loud, she will say, neighbors will hear. So I cannot cry loud. So she will beat me if I cry loud. So I have to pray until she calls me. And I have to kneel down and pray until she calls me. And my mother puts my sister at the door as a watchman if I get up and run away. If I slowly get up, she will scream. My mother will come with a stick again. I also wanted to beat my mother, but I can't. I am very small. My mother is huge. I suppressed my anger. Sometimes I don't do anything to my sister. I just show like this, she will scream. My mother has no time to ask any explanation. She will just come and beat because she has too many work. She has no time to ask whether I have done something wrong. So sometimes I did very wrong. Sometimes I did nothing wrong. After all, suppressed anger came to me like that. And I invited Jesus. Then I was around 7 years. After beating, I will sit in the room, crying, keeping my head down. After some time, my mother will call me from the kitchen. Food is ready. The moment I hear food, I will get up, go and eat. I will forget, but still I am wounded. Food cannot give you inner healing. I invited Jesus. Then I saw a vision. Jesus of my same age, 7 years, came into that room where I was crying. He sat beside me. He put his hand on my shoulders. And he started to cry the same way as I was crying. I asked him, "Did my mother also beat you?" I could really feel no advice, nothing, crying. I felt so consoled, and I heard like this, "Forgive your mother, bless her, you are my servant." Sisters and brothers, I have great, great respect for my mom, because that's why I'm a priest today. She has never beaten me anywhere, only before the Lord. Jesus consoled me, saying, "You need to be disciplined." Sisters and brothers, that was a healing. Since then, you know Psalm 56:8, "I have kept count of your tossings. I have collected your tears in my bottle." Psalm 56:8, together we read, "You have kept count of my tossings. Put my tears in." Is it not enough that your pain, your sorrows, your tears are noticed by Jesus? That's enough. That is healing. You don't want to convince your mother, your brother, your sister, anyone. Your master is aware of what you have gone through. And he is going to bring something very good out of your life. And he is there to heal you. He is not like any human counselor. No human can cry like Jesus. There is no one who can bring such profound healing in your life. Jesus can. He has done it, and he is here to do it in your life. And that's why there is no tears that has come from your eyes that has gone in vain. He has seen it, and he is here to heal you. Everything that you have suffered is known to him. Do you believe that? And he is alive. He is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Every pain that you have gone through, he is there to heal, and you need that healing. You have to personally surrender your life to God. And remember, your life is very special, specific. Don't compare your life with anyone. When you receive the healing as a Christian, it will be a healing for your children, for your family, for your relations. Many times parents are very upset with their children, but if the parents receive healing, children will also receive healing. Let's kindly stand before the Lord. Jesus, keep your hands on your heart, close your eyes. Since we are formed in the womb of our mother, until today, we are getting wounded. And we always have this tendency to accuse others for being like this. Some of us having this habit of accusing your wife's family, husband's family, your father, your mother, saying if they helped you a little more, if they looked after you better, you could have been a better person. Let us stop blaming anyone. Christ is our healer. There is healing. with him. If your mother did not love you when you were 1 year old, remember, she cannot do it again, but your Jesus can. If you have lost your father, your Jesus was there. He can restore that. Pray after me. Abba, Father.
Abba, Father.
I give my life to you.
I give my life to you.
I believe. You are my true father. You created me. I surrender my life to you.
I come to you.
The way I am.
With all my wounds.
With all my pains.
With all my struggles.
Oh, Abba, Father.
Help me.
Heal me.
Set me free.
I surrender to you.
All my wounds.
My Lord Jesus.
My healer.
My Savior.
I believe.
You shed your blood.
And purchased me.
You purchased me.
Oh Jesus.
I offer to you.
My rejection.
My fear.
My sorrow.
My sufferings.
My sicknesses.
All my stress.
My anxiety.
All my worries.
All my inner wounds.
Come, Lord Jesus.
Into my heart.
Into my heart.
Come, Lord Jesus.
And set me free.
And heal me.
O Holy Spirit.
O my Holy Spirit.
I beg you.
To come inside me.
You are my helper.
You are my teacher.
You are my defender.
You are my advocate.
Where else I will go?
You removed
fear
from the hearts of the disciples.
You gave them
courage,
confidence.
You led them
in the difficult situations.
Come, O Holy Spirit.
Into my heart.
Come, Holy Spirit.
I invite you.
Hallelujah.
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 Into my heart. kindly be seated. Close your eyes. Feel that Jesus is just standing in front of you. Close your eyes. The crucified Lord Jesus is hanging on the cross, is pouring out his blood, is there on the cross. Do you know why he is there on the cross? It's for you. So that you receive healing. So that you receive life. He gave up his life. He died and conquered death. He suffered and conquered suffering. He carried our sicknesses in his body and gave us healing. Feel it. And invite him into every area of your life. It begins with the desire of, it begins with your ancestors, your family, family tree, your grandparents, the family, the surname that you have. Jesus, I invite you into my family tree where I am born. I thank you for everything good I inherited from my family tree. The wealth, the treasures, the health, the property, everything good that I inherited. Lord, I say, I am very grateful and I thank you. Lord, I am also deeply sorry for any unrepented sin in my family tree. Anything that has gone wrong, any financial or spiritual debt. Lord, I'm very sorry. Jesus, you yourself born in a family, please come and set my family tree free. Repeat after me. Jesus born in a family.
Jesus born in a family.
Set my family tree free.
Set my family tree free.
Jesus born in a family.
Set my family tree free.
Jesus, I invite you into my family tree. If marriage is not taking place, if there is abortion taken place, if there is financial stagnation, if there is always severe financial crisis and stagnation, if childlessness in my family tree, if separation of the married couples, of mysterious accidents or deaths, or certain hereditary sicknesses repeatedly happening, if any kind of misbehaviors, criminal activity, imprisonment, any kind of things that are not really normal, and any kinds of things I have heard happened, selling or producing of alcohol, or doing some business that are not proper, taking interest on money lent. Lord, I don't know. I have only heard. I surrender everything to you. I invite you into my family tree, into my ancestors. I beg you, you take charge. You be the father of my entire family history. Jesus, you had a family history. You have a genealogy. Beginning that of Adam, Abraham, and David. Even in your family tree, they were women who were criminals, who were not really proper. But since you are born, the entire family tree became holy and sanctified. I beg you, Jesus, come and take charge of my family as I invite you into my family tree. Let's raise both our hands. Please call the name of Jesus as I will be praying a prayer for your family and family history. Let's repeatedly call the name of Jesus as I tell you, until I tell you to stop. Hallelujah. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Louder. Just call his name. Jesus. Jesus. You shed your blood and purchased us. Your priest, I pray for all those who are gathered here. If anyone is afflicted by any kind of hereditary, traditional, elemental spirits, or any kind of evil attack that is dominated for many years and centuries, let it be broken in your mighty holy name. Let them be healed and delivered from any kind of satanic affliction, oppression, obsession, or possession. If anyone in our family tree attacked by mental, physical, or emotional sickness, let them be delivered. If in our family tree there is a problem that marriages are not taking place at the proper time, childlessness, financial loss, no business flourishing, joblessness, any kind of criminal actions, let our family and family tree be delivered and be set free in your name. Lord, in your name, we pray for all those who are gathered here, calling out your name. If any abortion or any untoward incident, any sudden or unprovided death happened in our family tree, we deeply repent and we renounce all these things in Jesus' name. We command all these departed souls at your mercy. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon them. May the souls of all the faithful departed in our family tree rest in peace in your mighty holy name. We invite your power in our family tree. Let marriages take place. Let the jobless receive job. Let the homeless receive home. Let the hopeless receive hope. Jesus, 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 we call him. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Raise your hands.
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
Everybody together. Chapter 18, verse 10. Proverbs 18:10. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run into it and are safe. Lord Jesus, you know your name is powerful. The moment we call your name into our family, family tree, and family history, you come and take over. Jesus, you reign over my family. You be the king of my family. You be the ruler of my family and protect my family from every harm. Cover my family in your precious blood and set me free. If anything that is not proper, if that is not approved by you happening in my family property, in my compound, I surrender it up to you. We claim this word of God for our family tree from Zechariah chapter 9 verse 8. Zechariah, prophet Zechariah chapter 9 verse 8. Let us claim this word of God for our family together louder. Then I will encamp at my house as a guard. No oppressor shall again. For now I have... Please repeat after me. This is called claiming the word of God. How do we claim a promise? Repeat after me. Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
Please encamp at my house.
Please encamp at my house.
As a guard.
As a guard.
So that
no one shall march
to and fro. No oppressor shall again overrun. My house,
my
land,
my property.
Lord Jesus,
please see with your own eyes.
Give us protection.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Please pray after me.
Lord Jesus,
set me,
my family,
my children,
from every bondage,
bad habit,
wrong relation,
inherited
from our ancestors.
Shower me
with your blood.
1 Peter 1, 18, 19 also we claim. 1 Peter 1, verses 18 and 19. 1 Peter chapter 1, 18 and 19. Together let us repeat.
Not with perishable things like silver or gold, but with the precious blood of Christ, like that of a lamb, without defect or blemish.
Repeat after me, we are going to claim this word of God. I know that.
I am ransomed
from the futile ways,
inherited
from my ancestors.
Not with perishable things like silver or gold,
but with the precious blood of Christ,
like that of a lamb,
without defect or blemish.
I claim
the power of the blood of Jesus
upon my family tree,
and I declare
my family
belongs to Jesus.
As for me and my family,
we will serve Abba Father.
As for me and my children,
we will serve Lord Jesus.
As for me and my kids,
we serve Holy Spirit.
Hallelujah.
Close your eyes. Lord Jesus, I invite you into the desire of my parents. I don't know what was their desire when they were planning to conceive me, purify it. If they had any lustful, impure, hateful desire, remove it from their heart. Lord, I beg you to purify the desire of my parents. Let them receive love. Let me be created out of that love between my dad and my mom. Purify it, O Lord. And I beg you to come into the moment of my conception, the moment I was conceived in the womb of my mom. Take it in your hand. Take in your hand the fetus that I am. Wash it in your precious blood and cleanse me from every impurity, every sin that may be transmitted to me through my parents. Tell me that I am born for you. And I beg you to come to the intrauterinal period, the moments, the time I was inside the womb of my mom, every feeling of my mom, every sorrow, misunderstanding, persecution, every kind of accusation my mother heard from my husband, husband's family, Lord, it transmitted to me. My mother was so emotional, and that emotion came to me. My mother was hiding because she was never accepted by my in-laws. That is coming to me. I don't accept anyone. I don't like facing anyone. My mother went through all these when she was pregnant. She was afraid to tell anyone. She thought even to commit suicide. She thought even thought to abort me. Everything affected me. Her fear, her sorrow, her anxiety, it was transmitted to me inside the womb of my mom. Come, Lord Jesus, You entered inside the room the disciples were hiding out of fear. You entered inside that room and you told them, peace be with you. Tell me that same word inside the womb of my mom and tell me, I am born for you and you are there for me. I invite you, Lord, the day I was born, my dad refused to see me. He wanted a boy and I was a girl. He wanted a girl and I was a boy. They don't want any more child. They already had many children. And I was born premature. I was not looking nice. Lot of things. The first feeling when I am born to this world was rejection. Lord, please take me in your hand. Hug me close. Tell me that I am born for you. I am your child. Lord Jesus, I am your child. I know I am your child. More than my father, my mother, I am born for you. 2 Maccabees 7:22. The mother of the Maccabees is telling, I do not know how you came into being in my womb. It was not I who gave you life and breath. It is your God. The Lord is telling you that it is He who gave you birth. I am your child. Just let us say, Lord Jesus, I am your child. Every day, every hour, I can feel your healing power. Let's all sing together louder. Kindly stand wherever you are. Close your eyes. Jesus is standing in front of you. He's coming to hug you. Let everyone hear that you have a father and you are a child of Jesus. He's never tired of you. You are born for Him. He will never give you up. Even if the whole world abandons you, they accuse you, your Jesus will never, never reject you. Amen. Let everyone hear that. I am the child of my Lord Jesus. Everybody, you have to feel that you are hugging the body of Jesus. Feel it. Some of you can feel it. Jesus is standing in front of you. hold him tight and cry, I'm your child, Lord Jesus, I'm your child. We sing again.
I'm your child, Lord Jesus, I'm your child.
Everybody together. Hands on your heart. You are God's child. You are His daughter. I am your daughter. Lord Jesus, I am your daughter. All the women, now you close your eyes. Let everyone here, maybe you have gone through that pain of rejection. Maybe you are not accepted the way you are. You are telling now, I am your daughter, Lord Jesus. I am your daughter.
I'm your daughter, Lord Jesus, I'm your daughter. I'm your daughter, Lord Jesus, I'm your daughter. Every day we are, I can feel your healing power. I'm your daughter, Lord Jesus, I'm your daughter.
Son, all the men will sing. Alexander, God is calling you by name. He's standing beside you, consoling you. I am your son, Lord Jesus, I'm your son. Every man, you will sing.
I'm your son, Lord Jesus, I'm your son.
I can see a vision that Jesus is lifting Peter from the water. When Peter was sinking in the water, Jesus came quickly and lifted him up. The Lord is lifting up many men from hidden, secret, bad habits right now. When you are declaring, I am your son. God is also calling 11 young boys to become priests right now. You feel that call inside your heart. Once again, I am your son, Lord Jesus, I'm your son.
I'm your son, Lord Jesus, I'm your son. I'm your son, Lord Jesus, I'm your son. Jesus, I'm your son, I'm your son.
somebody while working in the factory, you fell down, you broke your left shoulders. Since then you cannot walk. Your company abandoned you, nobody paid for you, you struggled alone in the hospital. The Lord is healing a person from that wound of rejection, pain, agony. He is giving you physical, emotional and spiritual healing as you have been broken your left shoulders while walking. God is also blessing a family. You are crying and praying for more children. You have only one child. God is blessing many families to receive more children as you are claiming that you are God's children. Once again, let us kindly be seated. Close our eyes. Lord Jesus, I invite you into my infancy, my early childhood. I struggled a lot. I suffered extreme poverty. There was days there was no food. My father was a drunkard. He used to beat my mom. I suffered a lot. I had full of fear. I had nowhere to go. I am brought up by my uncle, my aunt, my stepmother. Nobody loved me. I was moving from one place to the other. I could not go to school in time. In the school, I was punished. I failed in the exam. When I failed in the exam, my dad told me I'm good for nothing. That pierced my heart. My mom was always sick. I never enjoyed my childhood. I had to struggle. My friends used to go to play. I could not go. I was brought up in a very, very pathetic situation. My friends tried to abuse me. I suffered. I cried. Nobody stopped my tears. Nobody listened to me. I was falsely accused. Jesus, come into my childhood, into my school days. I invite you into my teenage years. My friends introduced me to wrong things. I started bad habits. They put me into pornographic things. They introduced me to impure things. Jesus, that which affected me those days are still following me. I invite you into my youth, my friendships, many that broke down. I started to hate myself. I thought I am not good at all. I invite you into my time I was supposed to get married. So many blocks, as if it will never work. I tried many things and many things failed. Those whom I trusted, they cheated me. Those whom I loved, they did not love me. I started drinking alcohol. Even now, I cannot stop. I did it secretly. Tried drugs, tried smokes. Lord Jesus, I cannot help myself. I'm in a deep pit, a pit of bad habits, sexual impurities, uncontrollable sexual desires. Lord, I'm a slave. You alone can set me free. I tried everything to stop certain things. Sometimes I feel ashamed of myself. Jesus, you know how much I hate sin. I don't like to commit certain sin at all. But Lord, you know I am very weak. I am helpless. I cannot stop certain habits. That's why I have come to you, Jesus. You said, if the Son sets you free, you will be free indeed. I believe in your power. I believe in your name. I believe in your blood. Jesus, please come and change my heart. Change my life. Where else I will go? Who else will help me? I invite you into every bad habit of mine. Adultery, alcoholism, drunkenness, drug abuse, wrong relationships, addiction to pornography, talking too much, gossiping, lying, cheating, pretending. Jesus, I need deliverance. I need to become a new person. Please let us kindly stand. All those who have the gift of tongues, all those who can worship God, let us worship. Let us kindly stand. This is the day The Lord is going to set us free. He is here. He is in the Blessed Sacrament. We need deliverance from bad habits. He can.
Blind Bartimaeus cried, "Jesus, Son of David, have pity on me." People shouted. They told them, "Why are you screaming? You shut up." Bartimaeus did not stop. He screamed louder. Then the apostles told them, "We told you to shut your mouth. Why are you screaming? Master is busy." But Bartimaeus cried louder, because Bartimaeus came to know these people can only stop him. They can only tell him to shut up, but none of them can heal him. He cried in the past, no one helped him. He wanted food, no one listened to him. Now the Son of David is passing by. He screamed. Jesus stopped. Jesus called him and told him, "What do you want me to do?" He said, "Master, I want to be healed." Jesus said, "Receive the healing. Your faith has healed you." Sisters and brothers, that same Jesus is here. If you are willing to cry like Bartimaeus, you will receive that healing. People are surrounding you. Crowd is surrounding you. Let no one block you. Your Jesus is here. He is here to set you free. If the Son sets you free, you will be free indeed from your long time bad habit, that bondage. You know you hate that sin, but who can remove that sin from you? Jesus said, "Every plant my Father has not planted will be uprooted." This is the day the Lord is going to uproot that plant he has not planted, that habit that God has not given you. Raise your hands, call his name Jesus, or worship him. Let his deliverance come upon you. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Deliver us, Lord, from many habits, inner wounds, struggle, wrong relationship, impurity. We need deliverance, Lord. Louder, call his name. Call his name. By the priestly authority given unto me, Lord, I pray for deliverance. I pray for healing. I pray for new life. Let your people receive new life in your name. Let your people receive new anointing. Shandira bahala rabariya hala bahala 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 ba. Shandira bahala rabariya. Sania, Georgie, Cyril, Hannah, Jerry, David, Venus, Phyllis, Terry, Serena, Sophia, Ivan, Angelo, Chris, Charles, Agnello, Mike, Lorna, Agnes, Janet, Ellie, John, the Lord is here. Somebody who is celebrating the birthday today, the Lord is shaking your hand, wishing you and blessing you. Because you have set apart this day to worship him, is blessing you abundantly. Somebody, you have a special condition of your bones. God is healing you from that condition of the bones. He is healing you from that condition. The Lord is blessing a priest. You are praying for a priest
And God is blessing this priest, healing him and giving him new gifts to continue his work. God is blessing a priest because of your prayer. God is blessing a consecrated nun who was surrendering her life to the Immaculate Heart of Mary. God is blessing a consecrated nun for her consecration. There are some more than 15, you never experience the love of a father. Abba Father is hugging you, saying, "You are my child. You will never lack anything. That fatherly love is coming to you today." God is also blessing many married couple. You had no proper relationship at all. There was some kind of problem. God is restoring your relationship with the pure love from God. Your marital intimacy is blessed by God. God is also delivering more than 24 children who are into wrong habits. You as parents, you know it. You don't know how to help. God himself is intervening in your life, in their life today. There are somebody you are thinking of getting divorced. God is removing that thought from your heart. You have already decided to reconcile. God is blessing you for that decision you have made. The Lord is going to come into your midst. The Lord is going to come to bless each and every one of you. Let us feel his presence. He is coming down to you. For the Lord God Almighty reigns. Let's sing that song of hallelujah and let's invite him as he is going to bless every one of you who are gathered here.
Hallelujah.
above all powers. He's above all nature and all the created things. He was crucified and laid behind the stone. He lived for us because he wanted to die for us on the cross. Let us cry out to him and tell him he's above all powers. There's no other power that is greater than him.
Oh,
sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine.
Tomorrow is the final day of our retreat, and there will be special prayers for the families. So please come with your husband, with your wife, with your children, if possible. And tomorrow is a special day that we pray for the families, and they pray for the anointing of the Holy Spirit. As we sing a thanksgiving hymn to Mother Mary, you can go home. May Almighty God bless your return journey, reach you safe, and help you to come back again. The Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Mother of God, meet with your Son. Pray for us sinners, Mary, most pure. May God put cleansing streams